In my last video, we looked at mammals and their powerful, unique abilities. Now let's look at the history of mammals, how they came to rule the world, and who are their relatives. These are your relatives too, since you're a mammal. Think of this as your extended family tree, with your most distant cousins and grandparents going back 400 million years. 400 million years ago, there were no mammals, there were no reptiles, but there were fish. Fish breathe oxygen from the water using gills, but some fish lived in pools of water with low oxygen. These fish learned how to breathe the air. They developed lungs. They're called lungfish. Lungfish today can stay in muddy puddles and can crawl using their fins. Almost 400 million years ago, a lungfish turned its fins into legs and created a dynasty that includes all mammals, all reptiles, and amphibians. Now at first, they were still kind of fish. They were like amphibians. Amphibians hatch as tadpoles, basically fish, and they only develop legs as adults. To fully embrace a life on land, they needed a new type of egg, one that wouldn't dry out on land, but could still breathe oxygen. This is the amniotic egg. The amniotes had two famous offspring, reptiles and mammals. They weren't so different at first. If you look at the skull of a reptile, it has two holes where its jaw muscles attach. Mammal skulls have one hole for this. If you follow your jaw muscles up, they go to a single hole. At first, that was the main difference between them, two holes versus one. The reptile branch produced turtles, lizards, snakes, crocodiles, and dinosaurs. Oh, I just got some new dinosaurs. Let me show you. There's Stegosaurus, Diplodocus, T-Rex, and then Dimetrodon. Dimetrodon, what are you doing here? You're not a dinosaur. You're too old. They're 100 million years younger than you. You're not even a reptile. You're closer to a mammal than a dinosaur. On the mammal branch, there were three successful groups. First, there was Dimetrodon and the Pecliosaurs. Then the Therapsids, then the Cynodonts. Their success was interrupted by two big mass extinctions. First, there was the Great Dying. The Dying killed 90% of all species on Earth. Then came giant megavolcanoes. These volcanoes gave us the continents we have today. Beforehand, the continents were all glued together into one big supercontinent called Pangaea. The volcanoes ripped apart Pangaea into the continents we know and love today. This killed off much of the mammal branch, letting a new creature inherit the Earth, dinosaurs. Dinosaurs would rule the Earth for the next 140 million years. The mammal branch didn't disappear, but it was overshadowed by dinosaurs. The dinosaurs branched into all the many varieties you've probably seen. The T-Rex had a cousin who was smaller, who grew feathers, and who learned how to fly. This cousin is the ancestor of the birds. Dinosaurs and mammals had different lifestyles. Dinosaurs were very big, and mammals were very small. Mammals were probably nocturnal. They slept in the day and were awake at night. This is still true today. Most mammals are nocturnal. The mammal lifestyle helped them survive the big asteroid that killed the dinosaurs. This asteroid smashed into Mexico with the force of a billion nuclear bombs, leaving a crater 25 miles deep and 100 miles across. The dinosaurs and many of their relatives were destroyed. Mammals were almost destroyed, but they could burrow on the ground and eat almost anything. And they were so small, they needed very little food. Small birds also survived. With the dinosaurs gone, mammals could finally take their place. The mammal line split into many different branches. Different branches thrived during different periods of time, but most of these branches went extinct. Only three branches survived the asteroid and the next 66 million years: placentals, marsupials, and monotremes. And the monotremes barely survived. All that's left of them is the duck-billed platypus and the echidna, both isolated to Australia. Monotremes are weird, so weird that scientists thought their skeletons were fake. They look like a weird combination of a mammal, a reptile, and a fish. They don't give live birth. They lay eggs like reptiles. Then there's marsupials. They're born prematurely. They then crawl into their mother's pouch, drinking milk until they fully develop. Marsupials were once found all over the world, but they only survived in Australia and South America. Just one species managed to escape South and Central America, the Virginia possum. The most dominant branch today is the placentals. Placental babies stay in their mother's wombs longer, being nourished by a placenta. The placenta provides food, oxygen, and waste disposal. The placentals branched into many different subgroups. We can now determine how mammals are related using DNA tests. The DNA results are very surprising. Many mammals that look very similar are not close relatives, while many mammals that look very different are close relatives. This is explained by geography. After Pangaea split apart, South America, Africa, and Australia went their separate ways. Each isolated continent produced its own set of species. Each region had different specialists for eating insects, for eating ants and termites, for burrowing underground, and for wearing spiky spines. The insect eaters look the same not because they're related, but because they all eat insects. Geography is what determines the family relationships, not lifestyle. In South America, you had the Xenarthrarians, anteaters, sloths, and armadillos. In Africa, you had the Afrotherians, elephants, aardvarks, and hydraxes. And some Afrotherians went into the water. Manatees came from Africa. Meanwhile, North America was connected to Europe and Asia as a big continent called Laurasia. Many important groups came from Laurasia, like bats. Bats extended their finger bones into flying wings. They became the first mammal and the third vertebrate to learn how to fly. Bats soon spread all over the world, branching into many different species. The carnivorians originated in Laurasia, cats, bears, and dogs. Mammals with hooves originated in Laurasia. They're called ungulates. Many ungulates started consuming a new type of plant. It's called grass. To figure out how the ungulates are related, count their toes. If they have an odd number of toes, they're related to horses, donkeys, and rhinos. If they have an even number of toes, they're related to pigs, cows, sheep, deer, and hippos. And it's hard to believe, but these even-toed ungulates are closely related to whales. Rodents and primates also originated in Laurasia. Rodents are very common. They make up 2/5 of all mammal species. Primates were adapted to life in the trees and include monkeys, lemurs, and apes like us. Rodents and primates originated in Laurasia. They then traveled to Africa and somehow crossed an ocean to make it to South America. This seems unlikely, but even rare events, 1 in a million events, can happen if you wait millions of years. We humans are primates, and our closest relatives are the great apes. 20 million years ago, Africa collided into Asia, and 3 million years ago, South America bumped into North America. This set up an epic battle between the Laurasians and the South Americans. The Laurasians were the clear winner here. Many animals that we think of as being quintessential South Americans are actually recent immigrants: the llama, the alpaca, and the jaguar. For millions of years, similar mammals lived across Africa, Asia, and North America. North America had lions, rhinos, and camels until about 12,000 years ago. At that time, Earth was recovering from an ice age, glaciers were melting, and a violent new predator was spreading across the globe. This predator is us, humans. Humans and climate change killed hundreds of large mammal species across the globe. North America lost its mammoths, its lions, its horses, and its rhinos. South America lost giant sloths and giant armadillos. Australia lost giant wombats, giant kangaroos, and giant echidnas. The losses were particularly bad in Australia and the Americas. We've now covered 400 million years of history. This is your extended family tree. Your closest relatives are the chimps, then the great apes, then primates, then rodents, then Laurasians, then the placentals, then marsupials and monotremes, the cynodonts, the therapsids, the pecliosaurs, then reptiles and amphibians, then lungfish. But why stop there? Lungfish, then bony fish, then animals with a spine, vertebrates, then animals with bilateral symmetry, then animals, period. Then multicellular organisms, the eukaryotes. And then you're connected to all life on Earth. Plants and animals, fungus and bacteria are all distantly related to you.
For more astronomical videos, please click to subscribe.